watching out for you. This is KZI 9 News at 11.
What many had feared has come true. An Oak Ridge woman missing for years was one of two bodies found in a suitcase in Wisconsin. Thanks for staying up with us tonight. I'm Brian Richardson. Law enforcement positively identified one of those victims as Jenny Gomez. It's our top story here at 11. Both of the victims were found June 5th near the town of Geneva, Wisconsin. The first body identified was that of 37-year-old Laura Simonson of Minnesota. The second, as seen here, Gomez, the 21-year-old, last lived in Cottage Grove but grew up in Oak Ridge. Former police officer Stephen Zelich was arrested last week in connection with the deaths. Sources say he had relationships with both women and told authorities he was involved in their deaths. Officials say the investigation hasn't been easy, especially when it came to identifying Gomez's body.
Jenny was not officially reported missing. That's what took a little while. She had told her family she was moving, and they thought perhaps she was on with her life.
Daniel Nacy appears for the state.
Court documents say Zelich met with Gomez in 2012 in Kenosha and killed her shortly thereafter. He is now facing two counts of hiding a corpse. There are no murder charges yet. KEZI 9 News reporter Sarah Hurwitz has followed the story extensively since Friday. Tonight, she sat down with Gomez's family. She's live in the studio now to show us how this murder investigation that spans thousands of miles is impacting them. Sarah?
Well, no one is ever prepared to lose a family member. The news of Gomez's death is hitting her foster family hard. I sat down with Gomez's foster dad and foster sister this afternoon, and as they looked back on her years at home in Oak Ridge and the legacy that she leaves behind.
The room looks a lot different now. But memories of Jenny Gomez will always be here.
I'm gonna have to come back to this house and know that she'll never be here.
This is where Gomez spent her high school years with her roommate and foster sister, Kelsey.
Nobody deserves this, especially not her.
They lived in this house in the small town of Oak Ridge, and they weren't just sisters, but best friends.
She just inspires me. The way she looked at life is how I'm gonna look at life.
When the kids get to us, they've already had a plate full of stuff to deal with. You know, and with that being said, you know, it's like Jenny always had a positive twist on things.
It was no easy feat raising eight foster children, but Kirk Trout and his ex-wife were seasoned foster parents of 20 years, and Gomez just fit right in.
I don't know how you would describe it, but it's like once they come into your life, they're your kids. You don't have to give birth to them for them to be your kids.
And Kirk wants to shed light on some things that people may not know about his foster daughter.
She went to church on Sundays to help prepare meals for the families at church. And that was one of the side of her that I want people to know, that Jenny did have a big heart, and her intentions were in a good place.
Dances, cross-country races, and snowboarding. As Kirk and Kelsey look at photos of Gomez, they know she won't ever step foot in this house, but her warmth will always grace this room.
She was just happy to be alive. Everything she did was just positive. That was just who she was.
And Gomez leaves behind a young son. Now, the Trout family also says that they didn't want to speak specifically about anything related to the case or what led up to it. They just want Gomez remembered for the positive things that were in her life. Live in the studio, Sarah Hurwitz, KEZI 9 News.